Captain Jet Quillen, JETQUILLEN. So the latest on this developing story is that approximately 6:15 this morning, members of Pike Township Fire Department were out completing a surface search of the area of Eagle Creek where we had been searching for a missing paddle boater. They did locate a body in the water. That body has been recovered. We are now working on identifying the identity of that victim. The body has been taken down to the Marion County Coroner's Office, and they are working diligently to identify the victim that was taken from the water.
Who exactly was here this morning? Around what time was it, and who actually found that body?
Yeah, so the search operations were set to begin at 8 a.m. Pike Township Fire Department came out a little early, a little around 6 o'clock this morning, just to do a precursor surface search by boat. At about 6:15, a little farther south of the area where the reports of the person went missing were occurring, they located a body floating in the water.
That would be south of the marina.
Correct.
Could you give us a little background?
Approximately, afternoon of July 8th, we had some paddle boaters out on the water. There was a little bit of high winds that caused some waves in the area. Two subjects were thrown from their paddle boat. The female that was thrown was able to be recovered from the water by a passerby, and she is fine. The other person thrown from the boat went under the surface and was not able to be recovered. So a search operation was started utilizing sonar and divers from Pike Township, Indianapolis Fire Department, Indiana Department of Natural Resources Law Enforcement Division. So that has been going on for the past day and a half. This morning, we were set to resume at 8 a.m. Pike Township came out a little early just to run the water, and that's when they found a body floating in the water. Like I said, we're still trying to identify that victim. The body's at the coroner's office now, and they are working diligently to try to give us the answers of exactly who this is.
As you all are waiting to hear back from the coroner's office on a positive ID, how could that change things for the rest of the day? Would you all possibly have more people back out here if it's not the gentleman who went missing on Wednesday?
Yeah, absolutely. We have searchers and responders on scene to continue the search operations. That is our full intent, is to continue the search operations till we get confirmation that this is the victim we're looking for. So as of right now, we are game planning on what's going to happen next, but our full intention is to get back out on the water and continue the search.
Throughout these past, I guess at this point, almost 36, a little bit more than that, hours, what have been some of the challenges while you all were out here? We know it was the choppy conditions on that initial day, and Pike Township, it really took only about 18 minutes for them to immediately call it a recovery effort. What were some of the challenges that your conservation officers experienced yesterday and even that evening of July 8th?
Yeah, so anytime you have a victim go in the water, it's important to identify a last seen point. So that is really where we base our search operations off of, is this is the area we're focusing on. Once we can rule out this area, we will expand the search. When you're out on a boat in the middle of a lake or reservoir, determining that last seen point can be very difficult because the boat that the witness is on is moving, and it might not be reliable. So we had a very large search area to focus on. So when you have a large search area with varying depths from anywhere from 5 to 12 feet in this area, obviously the depth will affect the accuracy of the sonar. The shallower the water, the harder it is to read the sonar images. So all that comes into play. Through the last couple days of searching, possible targets were located, but those targets were deemed to be, stumps or submerged objects and not a victim that we're searching for. So those were the kind of obstacles that the searchers were running into. But you eliminate a target and you move on and continue your search and you expand your search. And that's what has happened.
Anything else you'd like to add?
No, I think maybe... obviously, this is a sad situation, and our heart is heavy for this family. but we want to urge all Hoosiers out there of the dangers of the water. Obviously, we want to encourage recreation around the water, on the water, but it starts with the conversations with the families at home to discuss the dangers of the water, making sure everybody's aware of that. And then if you're not a strong swimmer or can't swim, or if you're just not comfortable around the water, wear a life jacket. Obviously, we are big proponents of life jackets save lives. So if you can, follow those rules and those suggestions, I think a lot of this could be avoided.
Really quick, Captain, just going off of what you were saying about the tattoo on the forearm here, and you saying there was something small on the kind of the lower forearm, but you can't really tell if that was the tattoo or not. Is it possible, is it even possible that if this is him, if he was in the water throughout that time, that it could have faded or just anything like that?
Obviously, I can't comment on that right now because this is a ongoing investigation. I unfortunately, I can't. The coroner's office is doing the best they can to identify the body. But as far as details of that, I can't release those.
And then I guess, Billy, I don't know if you can mention this either, but how do you identify this body? How are they doing it?
Well, typically, if we have a body that is recovered that we can't identify, the first step is to try to obtain fingerprints off that body. And if there have been any databases where those fingerprints have been inputted over the last few years, we should be able to find that and confirm that identity.
Okay.